Good morning, good morning, good morning. And today's the day we are going for the first time to the Slam Dunk Festival. So, first of all, you're gonna have to bear with me today. My voice is a little bit croaky, so I might completely lose it by the end of the day, but we'll see what happens. But anyway, so we're in Leeds and we're going to the venues called Temple Newsham. Now, I might have mentioned this in the video the other day, but in earlier years it was in the town centre, but obviously because of capacity, they've had to change it this year. So, again, we've got to get the bus in. So, we're going to get that into the venue, and I'll see you guys in there. And we're in. After an effortless bag search to strip down, that all went well. Not that I've got a bag today. And my apologies, I think I've been pronouncing this wrong the whole time. Temple Newsome. So, apologies, I've again been pronouncing that. But anyway, we're going to try find, I think it's Punkin' Drublic, to see Annie Flagg. It's been a good day so far, and what do you think, Chris?
Mental.
I know. Oh my God. Couldn't believe I was busted turn up as a full slot. My childhood days officially relived. So, we're just taking a little break just now from all the bands we're seeing, and then we'll catch up in a bit. Just seen shapes and
bloody hell. Heavens have opened like nothing before. Like, oh my god. We're used to rain at festivals, but again, kind of damaged it a little bit. But anyway, we're slight change of plan to what I was originally intending. I'll tell you in the review later. We're going to see Neck Deep, Atreyu, and then later on I'm going to see No Effects and then Bad Religion. Well, either way, I'm Bad Religion, then No Effects.
Yeah.
good points and a few not so good points. We'll do a field review when we get back to where we're staying.
Okay, so I left this till the next day because we were both absolutely shattered last night. Chris is still here, but he's more horrific. As we just see, we're both horrifically sunburnt, so, which was... Yeah, but even though it was raining, which I'll get onto that in a minute. But what I'm going to say about the day was good. There was a few things that didn't exactly leave a good taste in my mouth, but I'll get into that in a minute. So we got on there just after 10. So we got a shuttle bus from the town centre. In previous years, as I might have mentioned, although we haven't actually seen it, it's the first time we've done Slam Dunk. It was actually this new place, Temple Newsom, which was more a festival sort of orientated area, where in previous years it'd been the town centre, and from what I heard it wasn't exactly ideal because basically there was the town centre like right in the middle of the square, and then they had the O2 Academy and you had to queue for places to actually get in, where this you could pretty much just walk into the stages and it was easy. And reminded me a little bit of Download when I went there a few years ago, where basically you just walk to the stages and that. But what I will say, there was a whole load of variety of bands that basically you had to really plan and strategize what you really wanted to see. First band I went to see was Anti-Flag, and they were on the Punk and Drublick stage at 12:45. And what can I say apart from they were absolutely fantastic. Them as a live band and the crowd were absolutely spot on, despite the fact I slipped and fell slap bang on my ass. But anyway, so they were good. And then my next plan was to go and see Boston Manor, which my brother there ended up seeing, but he said didn't really miss much. But I went straight to this place, the Key Club stage, because there was a special guest slot announced. And now, the rumours were originally it was going to be Breaking Benjamin, but they came out and denied those rumours and said, nah, it wasn't going to be that. But then, the game was given away by the fact they said, Y3K? And then, there's only one band we knew with a song that said Y3K or Year 3000. And that was busted. And that's who it turned out to be. And the two of us were absolutely blown away, because Busted were a big band for us when we were younger. Like, I've had a bit of a love-hate relationship over them over the years, but Chris has seen them a good couple of times. So, again, what did you think of them?
Who?
Busted.
Yeah, it was amazing.
Yeah, Busted, always amazing. And the first time I saw them, actually, but again, my 10-year-old self couldn't be happy. Although, the only thing I would say about them was, because obviously they were on, the tent was absolutely rammed, and I was trying to get it further to the middle just to get in the sort of mosh pit area, which is bizarre coming from Busted, but anyway. And then this absolute idiot tried to nail me in the back of the head, and I was like, what the hell? But anyway, I just continued. And again, I know I was packed in, but seriously, see if someone's just trying to shove past you. I know it's annoying, but just be like, oh, excuse me. There's no need to rap with violence or anything. But yeah, apart from that, this set was good. And then on to the next band we saw, Presto Meco. So they're like a new band from Croydon, and in direct contrast to when we watched Busted, there was only a few people in the Key Club tent. So, and this was the thing with both the Key Club stage, there were two stages, so it was a left and a right stage. And basically the way it worked is that, and the Jägermeister and Impericon stage up the top of the hill, is that basically, because there were two stages in there, basically when one finished, the other one started. So basically, if you were in that tent, you were getting literally like two bands for the price of one if you were there for just, if you were there seeing one band. But anyway, so Presto Meco, they were really good. And as we said earlier, they will definitely be seeing us again. So without a doubt, that was absolutely brilliant. So after that, we kind of wandered around a bit, and then we walked back up the hill. So basically the whole place was on the hill. We walked to the entrance, and then basically it was a little bit of a slope, a little bit like Download was, where the second stage and that were up the top of the hill and the main stage was at the bottom. The stages and that for this place kind of worked the same way a little bit. But when we went to see the first, what was it, story, no, it wasn't Story of the Year, it was who did we see next? It was in on the Jägermeister stage, Word Alive. Yeah, so went to see Word Alive. And now we found this a bit bizarre with the Jägermeister stage. Basically the sound, I think, was cranked up way too high. The main volume was cranked way too high, and we were like, wow, this, to the point it was actually piercing our ears. And that's saying something coming from us who've been to so many gigs, so many live shows like that. So that was a bit bizarre. Then the next band, Impericon stage afterwards, was Cancer Bats. And their crowd was probably the most brutal of the lot. Just everyone was going mental. And always got a dodgy feeling about hardcore dancers, but anyway, like, just again, that's just my opinion, but I'll do another video of that about gig etiquette another time. I saw Silverstein on the Jägermeister stage afterwards, but I only stayed for a couple of songs because after that the two of us went for the Key Club stage again. The stages were a bit, that stage, the Jägermeister stage in Pericon, that was up the top of the hill, and the Key Club Punk and Droblick was more at the bottom of the hill, and then the main monster stage was in the middle. But we went down to see Shapes, and their singer Griffin Dickinson is the son of Iron Maiden's Bruce Dickinson, and what can we say apart from he was absolutely spot on, wasn't he? Mm-hmm. So yeah, he was good. And although we gotta say, like, there was a few guys like in there who were pretty drunk, and this is why we didn't really go in the pit for them, because there was just too many younger guys who were just drunk, didn't really know how to do it properly, so we were just like, this isn't exactly ideal. So after them, we had a bit of a change of pace. I planned to go see Story of the Year and then Gallows, but we had a bit of a change of plan because this dude here twisted my arm, and instead we went to see Neck Deep again. Now originally I didn't really intend to see Neck Deep because again, I've seen them about three times, so, and their gig from the O2 Academy, which I saw a couple of years ago, I'll pink the link for that in the description. But yeah, they were good. It was surprisingly better than I thought they were going to be, because again, for me, like, you see a band like once or twice, after a while they're kind of growing, you think, I've kind of seen this before. Only exception I'd say was this for Green Day, Rammstein and Slipknot. But anyway, that's another story I'll say for another time. But yeah, when I seen Neck Deep, they were pretty good. Although, despite the fact it was just after Shapes. Now, up till Shapes went on, it had been dry for most of the day. When Shapes came on, it absolutely chucked it down. And as you'll see, as I'm about to bring up for the Bad Religion set, you'll have to see how rainy it actually was. It was horrendous. And I think for Neck Deep as well, the rain was pretty bad. It wasn't as bad for was when Bad Religion was on, but again, I'll get to that in a minute. So Neck Deep set was good. After that, we went back up to the Impericon Jägermeister stage to see the end of Gallows and then to see Atreyu. Now, Atreyu was the very first time I saw Mosh Pit nearly 10 years ago when I first saw Birth from Valentine. To say the least, Atreyu, now, their singer basically couldn't come over because he's got back problems at the minute, as some of you might know. So the bass player, was it the bass player or drummer, I think?
Drummer.
Yeah, I think the drummer or bass player, I can't remember exactly which one. Okay. But the drummer had to take over vocal duties, which was really good. And I think in that respect, they were slightly better. So again, I wasn't expecting them to be that good, but they were mind-blowing, to say the least. But I was surprised the crowd was a bit more, not lame, but I'd say like more chilled out than I was expecting. But anyway, just, I think that was just my opinion anyway. I only stayed for a couple of songs because after that, I went back to the Punk and Droblick stage to see Bad Religion. Now, Bad Religion are good, but because they're a bit older, like, there was a bit more of an old crowd there. But again, like, because they're one of these sort of iconic bands where, and up until they came out, like, punk for me was really, like, just, as you thought, was just, like, English and stuff like that. Like, the Americans hadn't really had a good try at it until they came out, and I have to say, like, they were really good. Now, onto the headliners. So, basically, the one I was intending to see was NOFX, but the only problem was, All Time Line, Bullet From A Valentine, who were headlining the Maiden Monster stage and the Jägermeister stage. They both went on about, what was it, 8:30? So they started a bit earlier. NOFX were meant to go on at 9:45. No, I think it was, 8:45, my bad. Sorry about that. But they didn't go on until like 5 minutes later because for some really bizarre reason, they were still checking their instruments through and like trying to make sure, because I don't know if there was some glitch or something, or something wasn't quite right, I'm not too sure. They ended up going on. And now I already knew that they were going to be interesting because Fat Mike's got a bit of a reputation to the point. This is why they don't really play in Scotland anymore. And more to the point, like, if it wasn't for them, all the bands that added, like, comedy to their sets, like Green Day, All Time Low, Barn for Soup, and especially All Time Low were headlining, probably wouldn't have never existed had it not been for NOFX. So what was interesting, that they came on and basically they didn't actually start with songs like, oh, hey, how are you guys doing? Like, sorry, I can't say this properly. Again, my voice is gone, so I apologize for how bad my impressions are. But Fat Mike, they just came on and it was so disappointing. Basically, just like, they were just going, just talking a load of crap. And
more the point, the crowd was so boxed in, like, there wasn't really pits or anything. It was just a load of guys with a passion in each other, and, like, you're trying to move, and, like, this is horrible, and this is the problem. When everybody's, like, actual, like, not really moving, there's not really much space to move, that's when it becomes a problem, like, especially for me. So, and just the fact, like, there wasn't many songs that I really intended. Like, I saw a song I wanted to see by them 6 years on Dyke, which was okay, but again, just the amount of crap they spoke, I was just like, this is ridiculous, I'm getting out of here. So I went back up the hill, tried to get in the Jägermeister stage to see Bullet for my Valentine, but that wasn't really working because of the rain. There was a big pile of mud right outside that tent, and there was this gadget to get in. Plus, for them, the tent was absolutely rammed. So again, I didn't really get in. I think the end of Tears Don't Fall, but it didn't really matter to me because I've seen Bullet for my Valentine a couple of times, so wasn't too big an issue. So instead, just went back down the main stage to see All Time Low. And again, they're a band for the both of us. They've never let us down at all. So they were good. And we thought they were going to play the whole Nothing Personal, but they only played probably like, at best, what was it, half of it? Yeah, so they were good. And they had a good few fireworks and stuff like that. And they got people on stage and it was all good. And then we went out afterwards. Now, I'd already had experience with this from Download, Transmit, and all that, but if you're wanting to get the bus right back up, and if anyone's doing this year, and if it's at Temple Newsom in Leeds, then leave just before the headline bands finish, because if you leave exactly when they finish, chances are you're going to be in a massive long queue to get buses or taxis and stuff, because when we were in there, good thing we left when we did, because otherwise it'd probably have been an uphill struggle to get back to Leeds City Centre, but we did, and that was that. So, that's it for gigs right now. And what can I say apart from, I'll see you guys in America this summer.